What's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm gonna answer a question. Someone asked me, hey Patrick, how do you handle aggregations when you're trying to do averages? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, so someone asked me a question. They're like, Patrick, I saw a video where you said if you have complex calculations, you should push them up to the source, but an average is not very complex. So how do I solve it? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show you. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So you have a model that looks like this. You have your fact table in direct query mode, you have your dimensions in dual mode, and then you have your aggregation import mode. And you go ahead and you configure your aggregation, because what you wanna do is you wanna get the average of sales amount. So you go ahead and configure aggregation, you put a sum on sales amount, and you go, I'm sure probably I can figure out how to do an average for me. So I created a measure that is an average. You can see right there. And then what I'm gonna do is I've connected up to DAX Studio. I'm gonna turn on all queries so I can trace all the DAX queries that are going to my model. And I'm gonna go ahead and refresh. So I'm using Performance Analyzer. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just refresh this visual. So I click refresh. It took a little bit. I can see it clearly hit direct query. Then if I go over here to DAX Studio, I can clearly see by the clear circle that it did not hit the ag. And they're like, Patrick, I'm stuck. What do I do? And I said, well, first, let's go ahead and get this query and turn on server timings and see what we're missing. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna double click. It gets the DAX expression up here in the editor, turn off all queries. I'm gonna turn on server timings, switch over to that tab, and then I'm just gonna run this because I need some more information. So it says attempt fail. Well, we know that already. Let me go ahead and expand. And it's saying it's missing an aggregation on sales amount. I know I have a sum on sales amount. Oh, I need a count on sales amount. All right. Well, that's easy enough. So however you built your ag, you need to make sure that you include a count of that column, whatever column you're trying to average. So in my case, it's sales amount. And so I already have that in my aggregation. So I'm gonna go over here, see sales amount count. I'm just gonna do count, internet sales, and then I'm gonna go find sales amount. Apply. And this is what my view looks like. So I'm just doing count, sales amount count. And then I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna turn off server timings. Let's clear that out. Go back to all queries. Let's clear that out. And let's start all queries back up. Let's head back to Power BI. Clear this out and refresh our visuals. That's pretty fast. Only a DAX query was sent. Let's go back over here. Definitely hit the aggregation. Let's go ahead and turn all queries off. Turn server timings on. Go ahead and run that query again. And then if we go over here, it says match found. And if we look at the XM SQL here, you can see it says select sum sales amount and select sum of sales amount count. And so it's running a query that looks like this. So it's just saying, give me the count of the number of rows, but I can put sales amount here. And it's just summing them. And so watch this. So I'm getting 62,000 rows in the table and a very large number of sales amount, which gives me an average of 316. If I head back to Power BI, there you go. So what you need to do when you're trying to calculate average, you need to have a count over the column that you want to average and a sum over the column you want to average to make that average calculation hit the ag. All right, what do you think? You saw this a different way? Did you know about this? Did you not know about this? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post the comments where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.